Hello everyone, welcome to my channel. I am Dr. Uday Pote and in this video we will see in brief about acute low back pain and precautions and care needed to treat the same. Acute low back pain is a very common condition seen in orthopedic clinic. It affects women as well as men, even if the person has a job of manual labor or a sitting job. It affects children and elderly as well. Back pain is a huge financial burden on the backs, affecting personal finances. The corporate institutes as well as government institutes suffer due to absenteeism due to low back pain. Low back is medically called as lumbar region. It is the curved area in your back. It consists of 5 bones. They are called as lumbar vertebrae. It also consists of discs which fill spaces between 2 vertebrae. It also has nerves and spinal cord. Large muscles cover the entire back region. Some patients complain of pain in the lower back, which may radiate to the back of thigh. This is mainly because of degenerative condition of spine, also commonly called as lumbar spondylosis. Some patients who complain of low back pain, which is radiating to the entire leg up to the toes, is mainly because of prolapsed or slipped disc.
Due to organized sports, young adolescents are into lot of acrobatics, sports like football, cricket. They present with low back pain. They have pain in this region. This pain typically increases by extension or forward flexion. When they extend or forward flex completely, at the extremes of the movement, they have increase in the pain. This is typically because of some minor fractures which go on in the facet joints of the vertebral bones. Other reasons like a hyperlordotic back pain, it is present because the normal lordosis is increased. This is normal lordosis, this is reduced lordosis. People with hyperlordosis, they may have back pain because of tight anterior structures.
Mechanical back pain commonly starts because of problems in the muscles of the back. There are sprains or tears in the muscles. This is more commonly seen in adults over the age of 30 years who are actively involved in sports like football, cricket or CrossFit. These sports contribute to lots of loads on the low back region, leading to sprain in the muscles. Certain uncommon but serious conditions of back pain are inflammatory diseases like ankylosing spondylitis or arthritis. Infection of spine involving discs or bones or soft tissues. These may include tuberculosis and other infection. Tumors of spine, which may originate from the spine or may migrate from other regions affected with cancer. As you have seen, there are many reasons for back pain. It is absolutely essential to rule out different reasons for back pain before we proceed with any kind of treatment. This can be done by your doctor, by clinical examination and x-rays. We need certain blood tests to rule out deficiencies, infection, tumors or inflammatory causes of your back pain. In certain cases, CT scan and MRI are needed.
Diagnosis is confirmed by your treating physician. They will advise you on certain precautions and exercise. Now let's move on to precautions. We are going to see what are the precautions to be taken in acute low back pain. Acute low back pain is any back pain which presents less than 2 weeks. In this back pain, it is assumed by people that if they do some kind of stretching, they will feel relief, which is not true. Stretching may stretch receptors will be stimulated, which may give temporary relief, but it may cause increase in pain. Stretching does help in soreness of muscles or muscles which were exercised and you are trying to lengthen those fibers, but it does not help in low back pain, and if it at all does help, it is just temporary. Acute low back pain, it's very painful to lie down straight on the bed. In this condition, we use a pillow which supports the knees, keeps his hip flexed, knees flexed. In this way, his lower back is relaxed. When lying on the sides, the pillow should be between your two knees or in front of your knees with the leg above resting on the pillow. In acute low back pain, the patient says that he has pain on turning. Now, the safe way to turn in bed is by flexing or folding the knees, staying relaxed, and then move with your knees, hips and shoulders in one sync. This avoids a torsion or a twisting movements in your spine. Get up from the bed. First, bend your knees. As we have told, log roll on one side. After that, leave your legs down and with your hands support your body and get up slowly. In this way, you need not take anyone else's help and getting up from bed is easier. Cause pain or increase the pain are flexion in the spine, and added to that, rotation of the spine and lifting weight. Now, this is a condition in which you flex and rotate, which increases the pressures in your disc, and in the weaker sections there might be a disc prolapse. In the gyms, it's very common that you, while racking those weights, you use a support and you just rack it, in which you can see that I am rotating my body while racking it. So commonly the patients complain that the exercise didn't give pain, but while racking the weight there is pain. So be careful in this movement. Now, in case we have to lift weight, you have acute back pain, chronic back pain or no back pain, in all cases you should lift weight like this. Now, this is the weight that I have to lift, and make sure that I stand as close as possible to the weight. I bend from my knees, hip and then the back, and then I lift the weight. In doing this, I can lift weights as much as my capacity. I can even lift the cylinders. There won't be any back pain. While sitting, we recommend using a pillow or a lumbar support, which gives support to your lower back or the curve of your lower spine.
We have already seen that the lower back is curved. When we lie down, we can make out this curve. This is a normal lordotic curve, where we can see a small gap between the lower back and the floor. In hyperlordosis, there is a larger distance between the back and the floor. On bending the knees and hip, the curve is reduced, which reduces the spasm pain in muscles. Bridging is one of the core building exercises. Keep the knees bent and hands on the sides. Use hand and feet support to lift the pelvis up slowly. In top position, tighten muscles of the buttock as well. Hold the position for 5 to 10 seconds as per comfort and come down slowly. Repeat this exercise 3 tummy tuck. Keep same position of hands and feet planted on the bed with knees bent. Put a small pillow or fold of towel at the lower back beneath the curve. Pull in your stomach, tilt pelvis up a little, hold this position for 5 seconds or as per as your comfort and repeat for 3 times.
Exercise for your posterior chain or your back muscles, wherein you lift your head up, try to lift your shoulders up, and at the same time you will be feeling lot of tension in your back and you have to squeeze your buttocks together. You have to feel lot of pressure in your lower backs as well as your buttocks. Relax.
If you have neck pain, on doing the regular posterior chain exercises, use this modification. Do not lift the head. Instead, lift one arm and the opposite leg as high as possible and hold for 5 seconds. And then repeat on the other side. You can do this exercise Camel exercise. Hands should be exactly below your shoulders. Knee should be below your hips. Look up. Tilt the pelvis down as shown by the arrow. This increases the curve in the back. Hold this position for 5 seconds and repeat 3 times. Keep hands exactly below your shoulders and knee below your hips. Look down, tilt the pelvis up as shown by the arrow. This arches the back. Hold this position for 5 seconds. Repeat 3 times. The cat and camel exercises open up the lumbar facet joints and hence increases mobilization. Gluteal muscle exercise. This exercise is for the entire gluteal or buttock muscles, especially helpful in SI joint pain. In this exercise, you have to lie down on one side. The leg on the floor must be straight. The leg above begins with a relaxed position where the knee is bent. Slowly push the leg back and make it straight at the same time. Hold this for 2 seconds. Then lift the leg straight up. Remember, the leg is pushed back and up. Hold this position for 5 seconds. Then slowly bring it down to the second position and then the relaxed position. Repeat this exercise on the same side for 3 times. Then do the similar exercise on the other side. Gluteus medius exercise. This is a very important muscle of your buttock. To exercise this muscle, stand along the side of the wall, lift the hand and leg near the wall, touch the side of the hip to the wall and hold this position for 5 seconds. Repeat it for 3 times. We advise some or all of these exercises during back pain or during recovery, depending on the patient's pain and his ability to tolerate these exercises. Please do these exercises under supervision in the beginning, and later on you can continue these exercises home.
Thank you for your patience. Special thanks to Ms. Vaishnavi and Mr. Tejas who have helped volunteer for this video. Please mention comment in the comment section below. Let us know which more videos you would like us to make. Please like, comment and share, and don't forget to subscribe. Thank you.